Atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease is not only a disease that is troubling a lot of Indian population, but it is seen that it is usually seen in a younger age group in India. In the Western countries, it is the young man who takes his old father to the doctor for a heart disease. But in India, it is the old father who is bringing his young son to a doctor for a heart disease. There are many contributing factors to atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease. Dyslipidemia is one of the very important risk factors. It is important because it is correctable and it is widely seen in Indian population. Effective management of dyslipidemia is very important and very difficult because of the vast terrain of Indian subcontinent, because of social beliefs, because of other socioeconomic problems of the patients. And I was surprised to know that it is only effective management of dyslipidemia becomes very effective management of dyslipidemia becomes very, very important because it is easily treatable and the prevalence is very high. It is very important and also very difficult because of the social beliefs, socioeconomic beliefs of our patients. You would be surprised to know that it is around 16% of the patients worldwide are having effective dyslipidemia treatment. You would be surprised to know that it is around 16% of the population, world population. You would be surprised to know that it is around 16% of the world population of cardiovascular disease who are on effective statin treatment or effective treatment for dyslipidemia. We have a goal of reaching around at least 50% of Indian population having a target statin treatment by 2025, that is 2025. This is the WHO goal for dyslipidemia. Effective management of dyslipidemia becomes very, very important. It is also very challenging because of the different socioeconomic beliefs and religious beliefs of people. In Indian subcontinent, we target at least 50% of patients who are having cardiovascular risk factors should be having a good treatment with statins by 2025, that is 2025. Lipid Association of India in early 2014 had consensus with the help of different internal medicine specialists, cardiologists, neurologists, nephrologists, vascular surgeons. They all got together to formulate a process or come to a consensus by which we could have effective treatment of dyslipidemia in India. There were around 8 meetings attended by 153 delegates in different cities of India, and in these meetings general consensus were raised. Statin act by reducing HMG-CoA enzyme reductase and inhibitors. Statins inhibit HMG-CoA reductase, a key enzyme that helps in the metabolism of lipids. It also reduces HDL cholesterol, which is free HDL in the blood circulation. It in turn also acts on the VLDL cholesterol. Thus, it acts on all different parts of the cholesterol chain, and it helps to maintain the ratio of the good cholesterol versus the bad cholesterol. The net effect of statin is approximately 25 to 50% reduction in the LDL cholesterol, and it also reduces the non-HDL cholesterol by 15 to 51%. It reduces the triglyceride by 7 to 30% and increases the HDL cholesterol, that is the good cholesterol, by 5 to 15%. Statins also have a lot of pleiotropic effects. These statins, when randomized controlled trials of these statins were studied, statins also have a lot of pleiotropic effects. The randomized controlled trials of these statins were studied, and it was seen that around 25 to 45% benefits of statins were because of the pleiotropic effects. And this was expected to increase with a longer duration of use of statins. There was a great number of risk reduction. There was a great number of reduction in the morbidity and mortality and risk reduction to the patients with cardiovascular disease. Statins reduce platelet aggregation and platelet activation by both independent and dependent cholesterol pathways. They also reduce the pro-atherogenic effect of the LDL cholesterol. They also help in improving the endothelial function, and they reduce the inflammation of the endothelium. They reduce the smooth muscle cell aggregation and smooth muscle cell activations into the plaque. thus reducing the plaque and stabilizing it, and also reducing the speed of activations of the plaque. The proposed mechanism of the action of statins in reducing the inflammation in acute coronary syndrome or in an acute event is by reducing the phospholipase A2 biomarker. Evidence suggests that the clinical benefits of statins is irrespective of the type of statins used. So we should use the statins depending on the amount of LDL cholesterol reduction that is expected or that is required for that particular patient. We should expect an intensive therapy of statins if we require more than 50% reduction in the LDL cholesterol, and a moderate level of statin therapy if we are expecting around 30 to 50% of the LDL cholesterol reduction. So depending on the amount of cholesterol reduction that is needed, we should decide on our statin that we desire. So if we are expecting a reduction of more than 50%, we should use the rosuvastatin at a dose of 20 to 40 or atorvastatin at a dose of 40 to 80. And if we want a reduction of around 30 to 50% in the total LDL-C cholesterol, then we can use the rosuvastatin of 5 to 10 mg or atorvastatin between 10 and 20 mg. Other statins like simvastatin or parvastatins can also be used. The clinician should sit down with the patient and the family, explain them the importance of statins, and then statin should be started. This is part of the good clinical practice. We should also tailor the statin therapy to our patient's requirement depending on the clinical situation that patient is in. We need to understand whether we need to have a high or a moderate intensity therapy for our patients. To summarize, the clinical benefits of statins come with irrespective of the group of statin or the type of statin that we're using, but the amount of LDL-C cholesterol reduction that we are expecting. We should at least use a statin which would give us the LDL-C cholesterol reduction that we are expecting. And in a good clinical practice, we should at least use a moderate to a high dose of statin to get some meaningful clinical results.